Hey everyone. So I'm here with a planner video, but this is to show you how I store my A5 planner inserts. I got a comment on one of my previous videos asking if I can show how I store my A5 inserts, and so this is that video. This is my current memory planner. It is my Carpe Diem, the first edition Robin's Egg Blue from Simple Stories. And I just brought out all of my planners here. So this is my first edition Heart of Gold Marion Smith planner that I use for, this is my unraveling, kind of like soul searching goal kind of planner. Then I have this Marion Smith. This way. Then I have this Marion Smith. It is the Luscious Pink. And right now, it was holding inserts. Like I was using, this was where I had my Heidi Swap memory planner inserts. When I was doing my memory planner, I had it in here. But since the year is over, I moved it to my Heidi Swap, the Heidi Swap binder. And I'm going to show you, because this is only half of the year in here. And then I have the other half of the year in this binder here, which is the Heidi Swap storage binder. And then I'm just pulling out all the planners. I have my Kiki K. This used to be my kind of blog social media planner, but I kind of moved some of that stuff into my Carpe Diem, my Robin's Egg Carpe Diem. And then I have this baby. This is my new planner. I don't think I've actually shown you her. Unless you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen. But this is the Ballerina Pink, the Reset Girl Edition, the Carpe Diem. And I have inserts in here already that I'm not using yet, but I'm just sticking her out here. So I have a couple of A5 planners. I do. I have a lot of them. I want to show you, though, first how I'm storing my Heidi Swap stuff, So this is the planner. This is the binder that it comes in, right? Obviously, this binder is stuffed. This is half of the year. I have half of the year in here. I have up until June, January to June, and look how much stuff that is. And so I was using it. I had punched it for my Marion Smith, right? So I would only keep a certain amount of months in here before I moved it back into this one, right? And so I was, at the end of the year, my intention was to just have everything in this one. I thought the whole year would fit in here. But as I got closer to the end in this and kept putting all the finished ones in here, this got really, really chunky really, really quickly until the point in which it was like that on my windowsill. And I'm just like, there is no way that I can store it like this. So Heidi Swap makes a storage binder, and it's a little wider. I think this is about like 2 inches or so, or maybe 3 inches. But it's a little wider, and so it can hold more. And so I started storing these inserts, the finished ones, in here. And at one point I moved everything in here thinking that I could fit the whole year in this, and you can't. I couldn't. So how I have these guys stored is I have January through June in here, and then I have July through November. And I only have July through November because I never did December. If you see, December is still in here. I never did December. Because I started doing December daily. And I basically substituted my December in my memory planner to do a December daily album. And so December of last year is in that album. So this is how I'm storing my A5 Heidi Swap memory planner. Half of the year is in the actual memory planner binder, and then the other half, and I think I could fit a bit more in the storage binder, is in the storage binder, and so I have these two as my memory planner storage. That being said, this planner here is empty. Now, this planner had other things in it, and I'll explain that one in just a second. So this is my other Marion Smith. This is my Unraveling. I call it Unraveling because it's based on Susanna Conway's class that I have, back here, that I periodically do like every year. I first did it in, I did the class in 2015, so I have the PDF there. But every year she gives out one of these little workbooks, your Unravel Your Year Ahead. And so I've been filling these out since 2013. So I have 2014s, 15s, and 16s, and this is 2017s. And so I had everything stored in here, but you know, I had everything stored in here plus a journal area that sort of looks like this. It's like very scrapbooky. Right, this year I have the planner inserts that Susanna Conway made, but before I used to do the lessons in Unraveling and put it in here. And so everything was in here, but obviously I don't have the previous stuff in here. So I would store all that previous stuff that was in here, I put it in here. Now I changed my planners around. Like if you've seen some of my older videos, you would know this is the planner from my Scrap with Love videos. And I did a lot of that in here, but I decided to combine that with my Unraveling stuff. Once I realized that I wasn't really doing it as much, I started combining it with the Unraveling stuff, and I had my Unraveling stuff in my Kiki K. So the Unraveling stuff used to be in my Kiki K, but then I moved it out because I wanted to use the Kiki K for my blog planner. And I didn't think the Unraveling stuff needed such a big planner because this is a little smaller planner. So I had switched it out, right? But when I set this up for 2017, for this year, I had all those inserts. I had all of the previous Unraveling stuff. I had all my journaling and all of my little scrapbooking things for the Unraveling class. I had it in here, but I needed to move that in order to set this up the way I wanted to. So once I moved out all of my memory planner stuff from this planner, I had moved everything in here. But I had all of these inserts from my memory planner that I didn't want to keep with the finished memory planner because I have an idea for this for another time. So what I did was I took out everything from in here. And I'm just like, I need some sort of place to put all of those finished inserts at that I had in this planner. Now, normally I store my planner inserts in empty planner binders that I have. That's usually how I store things. So like right now, these are old blog calendars and stuff like that. And so right now they're being stored in this Kiki K because I'm not really using the Kiki K. That's how all of the other Unraveling stuff was just stored in this binder because I wasn't really using this binder. This is my memory planner for this year. And I don't actually have many months in here. I have January through March, right? And then I have this folder, and then I have this, and then this is where my blog stuff. I moved my blog stuff because I just kind of wanted one planner for everything. So I put all the blog stuff here. My HipKit stuff is back here as well. And then this is YouTube. So all of this stuff was in the Kiki K because that was my blog planner, but I kind of consolidated it into here. But that being said, I don't have much of my memory planner in here. I just have up until March. So the rest of those inserts, plus the rest of the Carpe Diem inserts that I was using for the blog planner, are in my pink ballerina. And at some point, I'm going to show you how I'm going to set this up. But right now, I just have all of these inserts housed in here. So that's how I'm housing those inserts. But then I kind of thought about it. I was just like, okay, what if you guys don't have multiple planner binders to store your inserts? Like, I have the privilege of storing my extra inserts in my different planners. Now, I have other inserts. Like, I have Coco Daisy inserts, and I have these guys from Kiki K that I just kept in the packaging, you know, and they sit on my bookshelf. But as far as finished inserts, I keep them in the planners. So I was doing a lot of research on how you can store inserts and not keep them in the planner. And you can get binders. I know Filofax sells binders. They're storage binders that fit Filofax inserts. I already showed you the Heidi Swap. Heidi Swap also sells a storage binder where you can keep your extra insert. If you don't want to dish out money for like the Filofax ones, you can have scrapbooking options. Simple Stories, they make 6x8 binders, and these are binders for Project Life, and I'm actually going to go get my binder. I have one that I used for Project Life. It's these sorts of binders. They're the two ring binders. They're the ones that have the chipboard covers and the kind of fabric lining in the different colors. And there are two, you know, and then they have ones that are designer binders, and they look like the Heidi Swap one in different colors, like the stripes. But this is the one that I have, and this is what I did my 2014 Project Life in. So this is my Carpe Diem, right? I'm gonna just show you something. Now the Carpe Diems, the inserts are standard. They're standard A5 planner inserts, right? So the Carpe Diem inserts can fit in Kiki K, A5 Kiki Ks, they can fit in the A5 Color Crushes, they fit in the Marion Smith A5s, they fit in like almost all the A5s. These inserts can fit in these simple storied binders. Why? Because the middle holes, on like the three holes, fit in that, like these rings line up with those middle holes. So you can go and you can very well go and buy yourself a Simple Stories binder, whether it's this one, the snap binder. I think they're all snap binders, whether it's the chipboard ones or the really fancy designer binders, which are the striped ones in different colors. And you can store your planner inserts in these binders because they fit. And they fit like, I mean, these are the Simple Stories inserts, so they fit nicely. But I was putting, like, if you measure all your inserts, like standard inserts, let's see. I'm gonna take out these because they're spare. So these are Coco Daisy inserts. So the Coco Daisy inserts fit fine too. And then these are Kiki K. The Kiki K inserts fit fine too. Like if you close this up and there's no overhang on the top and no overhang on the side, these binders can very well be your storage solutions to your finished planner inserts. Like I thought that was genius. Like it just fits. Now, for a little cost effectiveness, the rings here, these rings on the Simple Stories binders, they match up with the 6x8 Project Life binders as well, because you can use Project Life 6x8 Project Life inserts in your Simple Stories binder and Simple Stories inserts in your Project Life 6x8 binder. They fit perfectly. So if you have a spare Project Life binder, 6x8 binder, those will also, the inserts will all, planner inserts will also fit into those binders. Now, that's just a bind, like, these are binder options. There are more binder options. Studio Calico's new handbooks actually have six rings. They match the six rings of a planner insert. So you can actually just go and get yourself a Studio Calico binder and use that as your storage. The thing is with Studio Calico binders is they're a little bit more expensive. These guys you can find good deals on Blitzy and scrapbook.com. Like you can find really good cheap deals, maybe at Joann's, for these types of binders. Like I know Blitzy has the designer binder, the black and white striped one, for like $8. And Amazon also has very cheaply, like, so they're good. And this is my Project Life, but look at it. Think of all the planner inserts. It'll hold a lot of planner inserts. So those are options for binders. Now, I kind of on a budget, and I was actually going to purchase another binder from Blitzy. I was going to purchase the Simple Stories, the designer binder, so it can match my Heidi Swap black and white stripe. I was going to, you know, buy that. But then I make a lot of mini books using binders, and I have a lot of Project Life binders, and I just have a lot of binders, and I have a very small space. So right now all of those binders are sitting on my windowsill because I don't really have shelving in my room. So I was looking at it and I was just like, oh my god, I don't know if I can fit another binder to hold, you know, these sorts of inserts, my new memory planner stuff. And I was just thinking of ways, like, how can I reduce the size of the binder? Because you have all your inserts and everything, and then you have the binder, which takes up room. And so I got a little crafty, and taking my inserts from my unraveling these planners, the unraveling planners and my Scrap with Love planners, I made my own little storage solution, which is this little book here. I'm actually getting more rings because right now I have these two, the binder rings. At Michael's, they're called embroidery hooks, and they're the ones that just go like this. These are the little rings that you use to make mini books, because I make a lot of mini books with these sorts of rings. This is a piece of chipboard. It's a piece of 6x8 chipboard that I covered in American Crafts cardstock and then lined it with paper from Maggie Holmes. This is how I make my mini books. So, like, if I have my mini couple of mini books, I have a bigger one, but I have these readily available. But this is how I make my mini books. This is a chipboard, and then the back. This is also chipboard. And again, this one, they're the same. I like this size for a little mini album. It's a little 4x6 mini books. But that's how I usually make my mini books, with these rings. And they sit on my shelf like that perfectly, and they look really cute and handmade and everything. And so I kind of took that idea, and I had these big chipboard pieces. These came in that Simple Stories binder. They were chipboard dividers. I just cut off the little tabs and I covered it. And I did the front and the back the same. And it already had the holes lined up that matched the binder. So I just kind of compiled my planner inserts in here. So this was all of my unraveling journal and my my unraveling journal, and then my Scrap with Love stuff. You know, that's the journal part of this. And then here's the one of the dividers that was in my planner. And this is the unraveling of the 2014. And then I have 2015 over here, 2016. And then I have a little tab for 2017, so I'll put it in here. And then this was the back lining and the back cover. And then this sits on my windowsill with everything else just like that. And I did it chipboard cover so it could just have a little bit of protection. And that's another, like, sort of DIY way to store your planner inserts. I actually bought more of these, and I'm gonna wait till I get them in the mail, and I'm gonna punch out the other two holes so that it'll just be a little bit more sturdy. So I did this, right? Because I was debating whether I wanted to buy another binder. And I don't know, I love this so much because it feels like a mini book. It feels like a mini album, except it's just inserts that I had in my planner. Imagine keeping a whole entire year and then making this little cover with the rings and then putting everything in, and then you can decorate the cover of it. And it can be a mini book, like, of your year, even though it's just your planner inserts. And I absolutely loved that idea, and I'm just like, oh my god, once I finish my memory planner, I can just put it all in this one book, like, make the covers, and then put them all into with the rings and everything, and I can have my entire year in one book, because I can get, these are, 1.5 inch rings. I can get the 2 inch ones, or I can get the 3 inch ones, or as many, as big as I need the rings to be. I can just change out the rings and put all the stuff into a book, and then there's my whole book. So, like, take for instance my Heidi Swap memory planner, how none of the inserts fit in the storage binder together, nor did it fit in the memory planner binder together. But if I had made my own cover and gotten, like, maybe 3.5 inch of binder rings like this, which I'm pretty sure they probably make 4 inch too, I just have to do the research, I could store all of those inserts in a little book like this, and then it can just sit on my shelf. And it'll just be the entire year, and I can decorate the cover, say, you know, whatever, memory planner 2016, blah blah blah, and basically you can do the cover however colors you want. I just had this pink cardstock and this, and I thought that was really cute. So yeah, I bought material for it. Like, this is chipboard. You can buy sheets of chipboard for like 99 cents online, maybe even less. And then you can get a packet of these on Amazon or scrapbook.com, or you can get like a nice packet of them with a bunch of rings. And all you need is a hole punch to punch out the holes. You trim the chipboard down to size and you punch out the holes, and then, you know, your inserts are already punched. You just have to line up that middle punch, that middle hole, with these holes, or all the holes if you want to do all the holes, or like do these two holes instead of the middle hole, however you, whatever configuration works for you. And then you put them together, and if you get like a packet of chipboard, you can make like multiple covers. You know, if you get a packet of it, a packet of the rings and a packet of chipboard, and then I'm pretty sure we all have like an extensive collection of scrapbook paper, and you can just cover it in scrapbook paper or wrapping paper or whatever, and you can make so many different custom binders, mini book binders, that you can store your inserts with. So I ordered a bunch of supplies and I have them coming, but I just kind of wanted to show you different ways that I store my planner inserts. And once I get those supplies, I actually might do a DIY on how to make a binder like this for your planner inserts. But this was just a video response to one of the comments that I got. And I kind of put it off for a while because I was just like, oh, I just store my planner inserts in my unused planners, but I know some people might not have that luxury of storing their planner inserts in unused planners. So, you know, you have the binder options, because each system will have a binder. The Simple Stories binders are awesome. Again, Studio Calico makes binders that match planner A5 planner inserts. And then if you have a Heidi Swap, the best thing to do is get a Heidi Swap storage binder, because those holes match the Heidi Swap holes, you know, because that's four rings. But if you want to do it on a budget and you don't really want to purchase a binder, I mean, the binders, I mean, you can find them, you can find the Simple Stories ones cheaply for like $8, but then you have to include shipping. So you're going to spend about $15 for a binder to store your inserts, whereas you can spend, I got a couple of sheets of chipboard. They were like 66 cents each, the chipboard. One sheet of chipboard, I can make one cover. So I need two sheets of chipboard to make a book, right? So I think I bought four sheets, and so I have enough for another two binders. And then I bought a pack. I bought two packs of these, so I'm getting 12 rings. I mean, 20 rings in the two packs. Each pack that I think I bought was had 10 rings in it. So I could have gotten away with 10 rings, but I like having these rings on hand, so I bought two. And I think those packets that I bought everything on Blitzy, was about $3 and change, so I spent about $6 on the rings and like $2 on the chipboard. So I guess that's about $8. So it's about what I spend on the rings. I already have tons of paper, but what I spend on the rings and the chipboard came out to the same price, the base price of the binder. So, but I can make two binders out of that for the price of one binder, and I can customize it. And then the rings, since I bought so much rings, all I have to do is get more chipboard. I would have bought more chipboard, but Blitzy, whenever I put the quantity, it only gave me as much of as they had on hand, and they didn't really have that much chipboard on hand that I wanted, so that's why I only bought four sheets. But, you know, if I go like to Michael's, I know Michael sells chipboard, you just gotta hunt for it sometimes, or like Joann's or Hobby Lobby, you can get some chipboard, and they're really inexpensive. There might be like $1 a sheet, like a sheet of chipboard, and you need two of them to make a binder. And then if you have a bunch of these rings on hand, you can make so many different binders for so many different inserts, for maybe about the same price as one binder from Simple Stories or Studio Calico, or Filofax, you know. So it's definitely more cost effective, because you get more storage options when you make your own, as opposed to buying the binders. And like, I'll give you a size comparison. This is, you know, if a stuffed binder like this looks like this, and this is, you know, a year's worth of inserts, well, creative inserts, in this. And this can always expand. That's the great thing about this, is that you could just get bigger rings and expand this one, whereas this, you're stuck with however big the rings are of the binder. When I did this, I liked the potential of this more than the binder, so I ended up just buying chipboard and rings, and this is how I'll be storing all of my inserts in the future. And I feel like converting all the inserts that I have in the Heidi Swap binder into one of these guys, because I can just put the whole year together. And I like that idea of having the whole year together, but then I'm going to have those two binders that I don't know what to do with because I have the whole year in one of these guys. But yeah, so I just kind of wanted to show you that. And again, I'm waiting on, I should get my supplies tomorrow, so maybe I'll like hop on and do a little DIY on how to make a cover like this. And it's super, super simple. If you know how to make any sort of mini book cover, it's the same process. But like for a lot of the planner ladies that I know watch my videos, who aren't really into scrapbooking, I would love to do a DIY and show you how to make your own little A5 planner storage, little mini book binder. Great thing is, the same concept can be applied to personal size with these guys, because I don't think there are any binders that are made to store personal size inserts, unless Filofax has one, or you store those inserts in other personal size planners. But this, you can just cut down a cover that fits the personal size and punch it to how the holes line up, and there you go. You have your own personal size storage, little mini book. So yeah, so keep an eye out for that DIY video. Hopefully it'll come soon-ish. And yeah, I just wanted to show you how I store my binders and just give you like ideas on how to store your inserts in sort of binder format. I mean, of course you can store it in boxes and stuff, but that's not how I store. Like really new inserts, of course I keep it in the packaging and have that stored on my shelf, but the ones that are used are stored in empty, unused A5 binders or storage binders that I bought, or these little guys that I DIY'd. Anyway, I hope you guys like this video and have some ideas now on how to store your finished A5 planner inserts. Again, keep an eye out for this DIY. It will be coming soon once I get my supplies. And give this video a thumbs up if you like. Remember to subscribe, and I will see you all next time. Bye!